Hello there, all you amazing people. Today we are going to look at Bing and why I think Bing is the best search engine for developers. But I will compare this with Google. I've more or less switched to Bing at work. When I do anything scripting, coding, or anything like that, I use Bing over Google Chrome. Not Google. Google Search. Also, keep forgetting this. Remember to subscribe and like. Tell me what kind of videos you want to see in the description. Not description. In the comment section. I can't speak today. Or come into my Discord. I have a video suggestion section in there where people can suggest videos. And there is like a 90% chance that I will make a video about your subject at some point within like a few months or maybe a month. So let's just do a simple thing here. Let's go in here and I Python TK enter Tinder, Kinder, however you pronounce it. Make an entry box basically. So you don't want to chat. We're just going to search it. So this is what you're seeing here. There's a lot of, you know, AI features. This is actually really good, but you can see here already we are getting some code. You're already getting some code. And we're actually getting some useful, these are actually really, really, like Python guides are good, Geeks for Geeks are really good. Python tutorials is a really neat site that I found via Bing, because I don't think Google is doing that. So this is Google. Python TK into Tinker, or however you pronounce it, make an entry. You get a video. Of course, they want to push their video success site for you. But if you are at work, I do see people watching videos at work, but you kind of don't want to sit and watch, you know, videos for your from your favorite e-girl telling you how to put an entry box into Google via her tits all over the place, which sadly is a thing in coding nowadays on YouTube. If you don't believe me, go onto YouTube and you will see a lot of questionable people coding. We do get Geek for Geek, but there's no code snippets here. There's no code snippets. So you now have to go in and you have to again open, you know, Geek for Geek. But there's Stack Overflow. There's some Python courses. There's Tutorial Point, which is another great site if you're into Python and stuff like that. You kind of get the idea here. So we have to consent for them to take our kidneys and whatnot. Again, not a bad. Again, we have to consent for our firstborn to be eaten up by the devils. Again, great site. We should probably put an ad plug on. But at least here you get some code snippets. And these code snippets that you see here actually helps quite a lot. Because you don't have to go in here and look at all of these things here. Unless you really, really wanted to. I do it anyway a lot of times. But I just like that you get those code snippets. I actually use this quite a lot later. Because it's to the point and it's, you know, it's not fluffing you up and talking to you like you're a stupid idiot. Let's say we want to move a file from one. Move a file to another. Dictionary. And you even get like Bing chat going in here doing its thing. Sometimes, depending on how elaborate it is, I will find it faster than Bing chat can, or Copilot, sorry, before Copilot can do it. And I rarely look at Copilot. But what I would do is I would probably look at like, okay, I will probably read this. So I'll be using shutil, I think that's how you pronounce it. You set a source destination, a pass destination. It actually give you quite a good amount of features. Like, surprisingly, I'm using Copilot more on Bing chat than, not Bing, why I can't talk today. Look, people, I'm massively stupid, okay? I'm just trying to play smart on the internet, but I am massively stupid. So let's try and do this again. Bing search. I do use Copilot quite a lot here. Why didn't they used to call it Bing chat? I'm getting confused. Anyway, you know, but you get code snippets here, and it's actually super useful. Let's do the same shit here in good old Google search. Basically, yeah, you have to find the sites, but this is what I found out with Google. This is where the good stuff starts to happen, like mid first page, maybe second page, is where things actually start to happen. But like, look here, we have AI generated responses. Again, take it with a grain of salt. I have have gotten into problems where I was like, ooh, this seems like this is working, and then copy pasted in or wrote down or did what they said here in the AI told me to do, and then everything just stopped working. So it's not 100%, you know. But they also give you, you know, the sites that they're giving, they're getting their information from down here, so you can potentially open those, which I do quite a lot. So if I see something like Code Cam, Stack Overflow, I will open them, or they want me to accept instead of consent, so they don't believe in consent apparently. So what the fuck is this? This looks like actually a neat. I'm not lying. This is actually a neat way of showing an ad. It is really irritating though. If I want to code, they believe in consent. not acceptance, consent. But what I've learned by using Bing Chat is that I'm actually doing more coding. Here I have to. Also, it looks so outdated the way that they're doing. Why can't I swipe? This is not centered on the page. That's why I hate doing browsers in full sideband here, because Google, like in 2024, they don't know how to center their fucking page yet. It's kind of the same problem with Bing, so I almost always look at my browsers like this, but for the sake of this video, let me do it this way here. But just look at the difference here. Let's do this sound comparison here. Yoink, yoink. No, look at the difference here. Yes, it is a bit busy. They give you some more suggestions over here. You have your tools here you can go in and play with. You can go in here and do more. You can filters, travel, news maps. You could go in to do Copilot all by itself. But again, here, this is actually what I needed it to do. This is actually really, really, really useful. Oh, it actually explained where the code came from if I did this. Or I can just copy it. Or I can ask chat here, Copilot, what it want me to do. So it basically just give me the same answer as this one up here, more or less. Here, yeah, I get some links. I get YouTube videos. Home, I do watch YouTube videos at work. I do like to read, because I have to hear if someone is yelling my name because a computer decided to infect itself with like Twitch streamers running around with their tits out, or breastfeeding, why the boss is looking at them trying to work and stuff like that. So I kind of have to, you know, be able to be contacted like really easily, even though we have Teams and all that fucking shit. But people tend to, you know, people are arcade people, so they tend to come down and yell like, "Ken, this is wrong. You know, my scanner's not working. Someone put a picture of my penis on my as a background. You know, I can't move it." So I kind of have to hear, and also I have to hear what the other people are talking about that I'm working with, if they need help or something like that, or if they're starting to jerk off too much behind my back. I have to, you know, hear them. So at work, I like to read a lot, but I just feel this is so like, yeah, let's go back to 2010. This is more like, yeah, we are living in 2024. I never thought I would say this about Bing. Like, honestly, I never thought I would say this about Bing. There's three ways to improve it. And I hope that I'm drawing in the point here. Let's close a lot of this shit. Oh, they're also not into consent, apparently. The fact that you can just get code snippets here, and let's say Python again. This is how I normally search. I use the coding language that what I want to do. I'm doing simple shit right now, but let's say use LLM for image recognition, if you want to be a little bit more creative here. So this is like last language module, by the way. And they say like LLMs, image generators. So here we don't get any code snippets because we're going into a little bit more of a advanced territory. So if you try and do the same here, go over here and do that there. Again, it looks a little bit, again, just this fucking search, you know, look. You know, it's just like night and day using C++. I have a big mic in front of the keyboard. You know, here, calling C++ from Python. This is a close. Again, we have a little bit of text here. I should be logged in here, but you get the idea here. It's just so much better. And again, if you compare this here, boink, this is what you get. I'm not joking. I'm an old bard. Google looks the same as it did fucking 10, 15, 20 years ago. It hasn't gotten a lot better. I just feel like with Bing search, when I'm coding, I get more shit done because I don't have to look so much to get stuff done, you know, to get to the information. Because either you have stuff like this here where they're actually giving you, you know, feedback. You have something down here where they give you feedback on how to. They're just helping you so much more. And like I said, a lot of times they will even get you code snippets where you just see it directly either from Copilot or from Stack Overflow or some other sites. And you can just basically look at, oh, what's going on here? And then if you don't, you know, if Copilot or this suggestion here, because they're not always finding you what you want, you know, they're not giving you what you want. They, like, LLMs are still stupid. So a lot of times you search something and it gives you something you think you want, but you don't want. Then you go down here and you go in, you can maybe look at the taste of Python, more Python documentation, Medium, you know, Microsoft.com, learn from Microsoft. Is Microsoft even in here? Yeah, here, we have Microsoft here. We have Reddit here. I don't see that much. But Bing, as a for a developer, coder, IT professional, call it what you will, it's just so much better. And I'm a little bit like, I don't want to say this. I don't want to tell you this, but it is. Because, you know, we all know Microsoft, they are not, you know, they're not a good company. But Google is worse than Microsoft. Google is doing way more telemetry and data collection than Microsoft is doing. So, heck, if Bing gives me the best things, you know, at least as a coder, than Google is doing, yeah, then I will keep using it. I'm not joking. For the last year, I've been using Bing Search when I'm doing coding, developing, scripting, call it what you will. So again, remember to subscribe, like, comment, give me video suggestions on Discord. See you all later. Bye-bye.